A bubbly, happy little girl named Alexandra Rose Bourne entered the world on April 28, 1999. My mother, Jocelyn Taylor, was absolutely beautiful. Her laugh was always contagious. I grew up not knowing my father. I only saw pictures and knew his name. My mom left him when I was just a newborn. When I was around 5, my mom married a man and had a second child. My little sister, Daliani, the brightest, most loving child I've ever left my eyes on. When I was 10, my mom decided to leave my stepfather. My mom then became a single mother with 2 kids. I always had a smile on my face, and to this day, I'm a social butterfly. I tend to find the good in everyone, but I also had a mischievous side. Let's just say I wasn't an easy kid. I moved to house. I was born in Nevada and left at age 10 to Arizona. The three of us always seemed to live with my mother's parents. And then, at age 13, I moved to California due to my grandparents splitting. I transferred to many schools. I never quite fit in because I was always the new girl. I started to become overweight at 200 pounds. I gave up on my health and I got severely depressed. My mom decided to make bad decisions. I then had to let my family go and walk away. I had to accept what is, let go of what was, and have faith in what will be. I moved to Kentucky in with my temporary guardians, Jennifer and Rick McClellan, at age 15. They took me in and helped me get back into school. I have never felt this type of unconditional love before. They were there for me through my good and bad. I never expressed in words as how much I love and appreciate you today. I thank you for the encouragement and the inspiration to keep reaching my goals. I wouldn't be where I am now without your help. Every moment in this journey, you are always standing next to me. You helped me become the young lady I am today. I am sorry for the rough days, but I hope I made you proud and that it was worth it. I understood completely when Randy Bosch said in his last lecture, "Time is all you have, and you may find one day that you have less than you think." On November 2nd, 2017, during my senior year of high school, I had lost my Nana to ALS, Lou Gehrig's disease. She was my inspiration, my best friend, someone to talk to and hang out with. I loved everything about this woman. She inspired me to keep going with my dreams and encouraged me to stick to my goal as a special education teacher. Her death didn't hold me back, but pushed me to work harder so she could watch me become successful. I found myself the happiest when I am around people who have disabilities. The environment, the love, and the laughs always put a smile on my face. I made memories and friendships that would be cherished for the rest of my life. Growing up, I always wanted to have friendships like I do with the ECE program. I hope in the future that the world will be even more inclusive and accepting as it is today. At Butler, the friendships never seem to amaze me. The Best Buddies and Peer Tutoring Program helped me make a difference in many people's lives, as well as mine. Cody, my forever best friend, you were the one person that I was able to talk to on my good and bad days. Someone I could rely on and not judge me. You loved me through my darkest days and you were always patient with me. I thank you for being my best friend and being by my side. I can't wait for the new memories to come. Eli, Landon, and Grace, my unbiological siblings. You all have been so good to me. All the laughs and memories we have shared have been the best. I love you all so much and I couldn't be more proud. You all have such bright futures ahead of you. My advice to future generations. I want you to keep family near and be thankful for people who are with you in the hard times, especially through the 4 years in high school. It doesn't have to be blood either. I realize my non-biological parents did so much for me rather than anyone else. I was lucky to be given a second chance of life and become something great. I believe in second chances and startovers. I want people to know that I am not what happened to me. I am what I chose to become.